Let's take an example where we are computing the transpose of a matrix. This is the algorithm. It has two loops over here where the outer loop is running from I is equal to 1 to n, and the inner loop is running from I to n, and within this inner loop, this function swap is being called. If we can compute how many times this function will be called, then we would know the time complexity of this algorithm. Because we know that statements within the loops, they are the ones which contribute to the time complexity of the algorithm. So we have to know how many times this swap function will be called and how much time this swap takes every time it is called. So let us see what the function is and what is the time complexity of this swap function. So if you say, see this statement over here will take one time, this will take one, and this will also take one. So the total is three, growth rate is three, and we say that this is constant time. So we know that every time this swap will be called, it is going to take constant time only. But how many times it is being called, we have to see that. We know that this is running from 1 to n. That means it will go inside the loop n times. But here, j is not varying from 1 to n. It is varying from I to n. That means the inner loop variable j is dependent upon the outer loop variable I. So now how many times will this swap be executed? So to compute this, let us use a technique which is called unrolling. If I is 1, j will go from 1 to n. That means it will go n times, and so swap will be called n times. If I is 2, j will go from 2 to n. That means swap will be called from 2 to n. That is 1 less than this value. So n minus 1 time. If I becomes 3, j will go from 3 to n. And so swap will now be called even 1 less than this n minus 1. So this would be n minus 2. And when I becomes n, j will go from n to n. And that means it is just going to be executed once. So swap will be called once. And each time this swap is called. So in the first iteration, swap was called n times. And how much time did it take? Since it is taking order of 1, so n into 1 is again going to give us 1 only. Similarly, in the second iteration, swap was called n minus 1 time, and each time it is taking constant time only. So it will remain n minus 1. So the total number of times swap was called would be the sum of all of these. N plus n minus 1 plus n minus 2 and so on up till n. If you see that this is an arithmetic series from 1 to n, and the way we compute the sum of this arithmetic series is n by 2, 2a. So we can take this as the first term, or you can take this as the first term as well. So 2n plus n minus 1, and the common difference is minus 1 over here. So it is n by 2, 2a plus n minus 1d. If we solve this, we will find that the growth rate is n into n plus 1 by 2. The high order term is n square. So we say that the complexity of this algorithm is order of n square. Let's take another example. Here, this is the this is some function which is taking two matrices, and there is a loop which is going from 1 to n, and each time this function is being called, Let us take a look at this function sum. This statement is going to take constant time. This is going to take 1. This assignment is going to take 1. This is going to take n plus 1 times, and this will happen n times. So we take the maximum. This is n plus 1. Within the loop, it will go n times only, and return temp would take 1 time. So this becomes 2n plus 3. You can watch my earlier videos to see how the growth rate is computed. That means each time this function is run, it takes 2n plus 3 time. Now 2n plus 3 was when the input parameter was n. Here when this function is being called, the input parameter is I plus 1. So how much time will it take when the input parameter is I plus 1? So it would take 2i plus 1 plus 3, that means 2i plus 5 time. Now we know that each time this sum is called, it is going to take 2i plus 5 time. And we know that for each value of I, this function is going to be called. So let us use the technique of unrolling, and we see that when I is equal to 1, this function sum would be called. And how much time will it take? It will take 2 into 1 plus 5 times, because I is 1. When I is 2, this function will be called again, sum, and how much time will it take? 2 into 2 plus 5. And this we can compute till I becomes n, and this is going to take 2 into n plus 5 time. So what was the total time that was taken by this algorithm to run? That would be the sum of all these terms. We can rewrite this as 2 into 1 plus 2 plus 3 and so on till n, and there are n terms, so this becomes 5n. Again, this is the sum of the arithmetic series, which is 2 into n plus 1 by 2 plus 5n. So this becomes n square plus 6n. Again, we will ignore the low order term, and we say that the complexity of this algorithm is order of n square.